Welcome. Today in this lecture on the subject Mathematics 1, subject code MA 151, and the today's topic is review of matrices. So in this lecture we will review some of the concepts of matrices. Matrix is a very old subject. First it was studied by author Cayley about 1860, and since then it is being used in various branches of science and engineering. For example, this matrices have several applications. Matrices are useful in, number one, in solving system of linear equations. System of linear equations, and in solving system of linear equations and in quantum mechanics. And electrical circuits, and discrete mathematics, and graph theory. And there are other several applications of matrices. Matrices are useful in framework, in mechanics, and matrices are used in almost all the branches of science and engineering. The main feature of matrices is that matrices are very computer friendly. So we can handle matrices with the help of computer also. And we have a very popular software, MATLAB. This software is based on the concept of matrices. So this was about the application and importance of matrices. Now I will define the matrix, and then we will discuss various types of matrices. Matrix means a rectangular array. A rectangular array of numbers, of real numbers or complex numbers. Matrices, for example, if we arrange some numbers, for example, 10, in rows and matrices. So rows means horizontal lines. So this is row 1, horizontal line. This is second row, this is third row. Or by column we mean, vertical line. Now the main use of matrices comes from the idea of solving a system of linear equation. So if we have a system of linear equation, for example, suppose we have these three equations, x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 10, bx minus 4y plus 6z equal to 9, x plus 9y minus 7z equal to 11. So this is a system of linear equations. So there are three linear equations, and if you want to find the value of x, y and z, then this problem is can be said to be a problem of solving a system of linear equation. So it is a system of linear equation, and by solving it we want to calculate the values of x, y and z. To solve these types of system, matrices are very helpful. Even when the number of equations and the equal number of variables are very large, so we can have any number of equations and any number of variables, and we can handle such systems of linear equation with the help of matrices. So to handle these types of system with the help of matrices, we write a coefficient matrix for this type of system of linear equation. So it is a system of linear equation, and the corresponding coefficient matrix, the corresponding coefficient matrix can be written in this way: coefficient matrix of the above linear system. So coefficient matrix will be obtained from the coefficients of the variables, and writing them horizontally in rows. So I have collected the coefficients of the involved variable x, y and z, and I have written down all these entries in rows and columns horizontally and vertically, and then I have enclosed this array, this array inside the square bracket. So this type of representation is known as matrices. Next we will look at a term associated with the matrix. So before that, we can look at the definition. So as I told, matrix is a set of real or complex numbers arranged in rows and columns to form a rectangular array. And the same type of example is also available in these slides. So we have a system of three linear equations in four variables. So there are four variables x, y, z and t. And for this system of linear equation, the coefficient matrix is calculated here in the next slide. So if we will collect the coefficients of all the involved variables, so then we will get this coefficient matrix. So this idea will be of use in the next chapter, where we will solve the systems of linear equations. Now I will discuss a term associated with matrices. It is known as order of a matrix. So order of a matrix is defined as number of rows in the matrix by number of columns of the matrix. For example, if we have a matrix And if I denote this matrix by a complex number, and if we want to decide the order of the matrix A, so then we need to count the number of rows in this matrix. So there are 3 rows and the number of columns. There are 4 columns. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the order of the matrix will be 3 by 4. Because there are 3 number of rows and 4 number of columns. For order, we can also use order represent size of the matrix A. So it is important to remember that we always write order in this form, row by column. Next, after the definition of the matrix A, we will discuss different types of matrices. There are several, we can classify matrices in different ways. Number one, we have these two terms, rectangular and square matrices. So, rectangular matrices and square matrices. The difference in both the type of matrices will be in the order, in the form of the order. So the order of the rectangular matrices will be of m cross n form, where m will not be equal to n. So if in a matrices the number of rows, if number of rows and number of columns are not equal, then we will say that the given matrix is a rectangular matrix. For example, this matrix is a rectangular matrix because the number of rows is 3, number of columns is 4. So, number of rows is not equal to number of columns, therefore it is a rectangular matrix. And for square matrix, we will have order of this form, m cross n. So, number of rows and number of columns will be same in the square matrix. For example, we have seen these types of matrices 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1. So it is a square matrix of order 3 by 3. When we have a square matrix, then we can also use this term that this matrix, suppose I write a symbol B for this matrix, and we can say that B is a square matrix of order 3. Instead of saying that B is a matrix of order 3 by 3, we can also say that B is a square matrix of order 3, which means it is a 3 by 3 square matrix. So this is the classification of matrices according to the order, size, nature of the size. Next, we have these terms, raw matrices are also known as raw vector. We also use this term raw vector because matrix, we will see this matrix multiplication, they have like vectors dot product. So raw matrix will have only one row. For example, so order of this matrix is 1 by 3, and the order of this matrix is 1 by 4. So there are 3 columns in the first row matrix and there are 4 columns in the second row matrix. Similarly, we can have column matrix. Or column vector. So for column matrix will have only one column. Only one column. So for example, this is an example of column matrix or column vector. Because there is only one column. The order of this type of matrix will be 4 by 1. So there, because there is only one column. So this is column matrix, row matrix. Similarly, we have other types of matrices. We have studied row matrices, we have seen examples, we have studied column matrices, and we have seen examples of column matrix. Next type of matrices are null matrix . So null matrix is a matrix whose all the elements are 0. So these are also known as geometrics. So we have examples of null matrix having all the entries 0. Then we have studied the square matrices. When there are diagonal matrices, this term is only for square matrices. A square matrix is called a diagonal matrix if all its off diagonal elements, non diagonal elements are 0, and only diagonals of the only elements of the main diagonal are non 0. So we can see this is the main diagonal from top to bottom, left to right. So this diagonal is known as main diagonal of the square matrix, and in case of diagonal matrix, you will have non-zero values at the main diagonal only. Next is the unit or identity matrix. Identity matrix is also a very important idea. Identity matrix is a square matrix, it is a diagonal matrix having one at the main diagonal everywhere, at the principal diagonal, and all the off diagonal entry, non diagonal entries are 0. So we can have we have notation I2 for a 2 by 2 square matrix, 2 by 2 square matrix, which is an identity matrix. And we have I3 notation for a 3 by 3 identity matrix. Next, we look at other types of matrices. We have other types of classification for matrices. These, we will say that a square matrix is symmetric if the Aij entry is equal to Aji entry. So we have a notation for matrices which is being used here. If we have a matrix, for example, if we have a matrix of order 3 by 3, we can have this type of notation to write this matrix of order 3 by 3. These types of notations are very useful in understanding the concepts related with matrices. This notation Aij inside the square bracket 3 cross 3 means it is a 3 by 3 matrix with element of this form. This idea helps us in understanding the position of the elements. For example, we have this matrix, and if I want to indicate 7, so, and if I ask what is the position of 7 inside that square matrix, then we can say that 7 is in second row and second column. So we, instead of saying this that it is in second row or second column, we can specify 7 by this symbol A22. So A22 will mean that we are talking about the element which is in the second row and second column, which is at the intersection of second row and second column. So these are the symbols which are being used here in this definition. So if we have a square matrix, then we will say that it is symmetric even only Aij is equal to Aji. So if you look here, so A21 should be equal to A12, A31 should be equal to A13, A32 should be equal to A23. So if this type of situation is there, then we will say that the matrix is symmetric. If Aij type of entries are equal to Aji entries, and we don't need to check for diagonal elements in this case. Another way of understanding symmetric matrices is that if we have this matrix, suppose this matrix is A, and if I change the rows of the matrix A into column, or I convert all the columns of the matrix into rows, then I will have another matrix. So in the first column I make it first row, in the second column I make it second row, this is third column, I make it third row. So after transforming all the rows into columns, or after transforming all the columns into rows, I get a new matrix, and this matrix is similar to the original matrix A. In this case also we will say that the given matrix is symmetric. If the given matrix remains same after converting all the rows into columns, or after converting all the columns into rows, if a square matrix remains same, then it will be a symmetric matrix. Another point here is that this type of converted matrices for a given matrix A, we have calculated this matrix by converting all the rows into columns, then this matrix is denoted by A transpose, and it is known as transpose of A. Transpose of A, or transposition of the given matrix A. So if you want to calculate transpose of any matrix, then we should convert all the rows into columns, or we should convert all the columns of the row of the matrix into rows. For example, if I have a matrix B, and if I want to calculate the transpose of this matrix B, then I will convert all the rows of B into columns, or I will convert all the columns of this given matrix B into rows. So here I have converted all the rows into columns. So I have got this matrix. This matrix is the transpose of B. Here, one more point. This symmetric matrix concept is applicable only to square matrices. We will have most of the concepts, important type of matrices related with square matrices only. Here, in terms of because it is a rectangular matrix, number of rows and columns are not equal in this matrix. So for this matrix, this definition will not be applicable. So this definition is applicable only to square matrix. Next, we have an idea of skew symmetric matrix. So skew symmetric matrix for skew symmetric matrix, we have this condition that Aij position element will be equal to minus Aji, and all the main diagonal elements, Aii type of elements, will be 0. In terms of transpose of the matrix, we can define skew symmetric matrices in this way in terms of transpose. So a matrix is a skew symmetric matrix if A transpose is equal to minus A. If I have a matrix A and I want to check whether this matrix is skew symmetric or not, for that I can calculate the transpose of A. Now, as we know how to calculate transpose, so I calculate transpose of the A matrix by converting all the rows into columns. So I get this. So if I calculate transpose of the given square matrix A, then I get this matrix. And you can observe that we can take minus 1 is coming common out of all the elements of the matrix. So you can write it like this also. Here we can observe that A transpose is actually equal to negative of A. Therefore, it is a skew symmetric matrix. And if we are dealing with real number matrices, if the entries of the matrices are only real number, in that case we will have zero at the main diagonal whenever our matrix is a skew symmetric matrix. And this idea is also applicable to square matrices only, and this idea will not be applicable to a rectangular matrix. And in general, whenever we will have a skew symmetric matrix, the principal diagonal elements will be 0 because of this condition. But if we apply this condition, Aij equal to Aij equal to minus Nji condition. If we apply this condition with j equal to I, then we will have Kii must be equal to minus Kii. If I use this condition with I equal to j, then I will have this relation. So according to this relation, 2 twice of Aii will be 0. So Kii elements will be 0. So this is a type of matrix. Next, we have triangular matrix. We have two types of triangular matrices: upper triangular matrices and lower triangular matrices. This idea is also applicable to square matrices. And if all the elements below the principal diagonal, are 0. So the principal diagonal, main diagonal is this 192, and all the elements below 192 are 0. Therefore, it is an upper triangular matrix. And for lower triangular matrix, all the elements above the principal diagonal, above the main diagonal, must be 0. For example, this. So this matrix is an example of lower triangular matrix. So in lower triangular matrices, all the elements above the main diagonal are 0. Next, we have this idea, the idea of equal matrices. Idea of equal matrices says that two matrices A and B, if we have two matrices A and B, two matrices will be equal, will be said to be equal if and only if, number one, the order of both the matrices must be same. Number two, all the corresponding elements must be equal. So, in symbol form, we write these words in this form. So, this is symbolic way to say that all the corresponding elements must be equal, and because you can see I is also, so I cannot run from I, and J both will be N. So I will also run from 1 to N, J will also run from, you can see the order of all the matrices is same, M cross N. And if the corresponding values are equal, corresponding elements are equal, then we will say that these two matrices are equal. To understand this idea, let us take this example. So according to the definition of equality of matrices, we will say that two matrices are equal if and only if their orders are same. Now if these matrices are equal, suppose if someone asks us that if this is the case that these two matrices are equal, then you please find the values of x, y, z and u. So according to the definition of equality of matrices, orders of both the matrices are same. So, first condition is satisfied. Next condition, if both the matrices are equal, then their corresponding entries must be equal. So, we will have x equal to 1, y equal to 2, z equal to 3 and u equal to minus 1. So, this is the meaning of equality of two matrices. Similar type of example is given in this slide. So if two matrices are equal, then their corresponding entries will be equal provided order of both the matrices is equal. Order must be same. Transpose of a matrix. We have already discussed transpose of a matrix. Here we can look at one more example, how to calculate transpose. So for calculating transpose, we convert, either we convert all the rows into columns, or we convert all the columns into rows. And following conditions are for symmetric matrix and skew symmetric matrix in terms of transpose of the matrices. We have discussed these points also. Next is the orthogonal matrix. So, orthogonal matrix idea involves multiplication of matrices. We will study the multiplication of matrices later. Here, orthogonal matrix idea is applicable only to square matrices, and the condition is that the product of the matrix and its transpose must be equal to identity. In the next part, when we will study operations on the matrices, we will look at the idea of multiplying two matrices. How to multiply two matrices, that we will study, and then we will look at an example of orthogonal matrix also. So, we have discussed several types of matrices. There are other types of matrices when the entries of the matrices are complex. Then we can have other classification for the matrices. So that we are not discussing here. Because we will be considering only real number matrices. So next, we will discuss operations on matrices. So we have several types of operations: addition of matrices, subtraction of matrices, and multiplication of matrices. And we have already studied one operation, which is transposition. So transposition is also an operation. Transpose, calculating transpose, is a unary operation for matrices, because we can apply this operation on one matrix only. Whereas addition, subtraction, and multiplication are binary operations, because we will at least need two matrices for matrix addition, two or more matrices for multiplication and subtraction also. Next, we discuss addition and subtraction of matrices. Addition and subtraction of matrices involve one condition. This condition is order of the matrices which are being added or subtracted must be same. So order of the matrices must be same, must be equal. For example, if we have two matrices, one is A and another is B, we cannot add, subtract these two matrices. So, to apply matrix addition, matrix subtraction, this condition must be satisfied. Otherwise, addition and subtraction will not be defined for those matrices. Next, we take one more matrix, C, And suppose this matrix is of this type 4, 7, 9, 2, 1, 0. Now we can see that B and C are of same order. The order of B is 2 by 3. The order of C is 2 by 3. Because order of B and C is same, so we can calculate addition of the two matrices B and C. Addition of the two matrices B and C will be calculated by adding the corresponding elements. So matrix addition is very straightforward. If the order is same, then to add two matrices, we will add the corresponding elements. So we will add 1 and 4, we will add 2 and 7, we will add 3 and 9, like that. So we will have 1 plus 4 at the first entry, and 2 plus 7, second entry, 3 plus 9, third entry, and at 2, 1 position, we will have 4 plus 2. So this is 2, 1 position of this B plus C matrix. And at 2, 2 position, we will have 5 plus 1, and at 2, 3 position, we will have 7 plus 0. So we can calculate all these terms, and this will give us the sum of these two matrices 5, 9, 12, 6, 6, 7. So this resultant matrix 5, 9, 12, 6, 6, 7 is the addition of B plus C. Similarly, to subtract, the order of the matrices must be equal, and then we will subtract the corresponding elements of body matrices. If we have more than 1, 2 or 3 matrices, we can repeat this idea. So addition and subtraction for matrices is straightforward. Now we will look at the multiplication. The multiplication is a little bit different. So next we will discuss multiplication of matrices. Multiplication is a very important idea which we will use frequently during this course. So you look at this process carefully. So multiplication of two matrices require this condition to be satisfied. The condition is, condition for multiplication of two matrices. The condition is, suppose we have two matrices A matrix Suppose for matrix multiplication we have two matrices. One matrix A is of order n cross p, and another matrix is of order p cross n. Then in this situation the matrix multiplication will be possible. Why? Because the condition for multiplication says that number of columns in the first matrix, number of columns in the first matrix must be equal to number of rows in the second matrix. So this is the condition which must be satisfied if we are multiplying two matrices. The number of columns in the first matrix must be equal to the number of rows in the second rank. And if we have two matrices, if one is of order m cross p, another is of order p cross n, then the multiplication of AB matrices will be a new matrix, and that matrix will be of order m cross n. So we can multiply two matrices A and B here, because the number of columns in the first matrix is p, number of rows in the second matrix is p, because this condition will be satisfied, and in this case the resultant matrix will be of order m cross n. So m is coming here from the number of rows in A, and n is coming here from number of columns in B matrix. So this is the condition which must be satisfied for matrix multiplication. So matrix multiplication will be compatible only when the two involved matrices satisfy this condition. Next, we take example of for matrix multiplication. I have examples for matrix multiplication. So we take a question of multiplying these two matrices and find the multiplying A and B to find the product AB. Now how to multiply these two matrices? First, satisfy the compatibility condition of matrix multiplication. So the compatibility condition of the matrix multiplication says that you decide the order of both the matrices. The order is 3 by 2, order of A matrix is 3 by 2, order of B matrix will be 2 by 4, because there are 2 rows and 4 columns in B matrix. So the order of B matrix is 2 by 4, and because in A matrix there are 3 rows and 2 columns, so the order of A matrix is 3 by 2. Now we apply our multiplicability condition, multiplicability condition of matrices, which says that number of columns in the first matrix must be equal to number of rows in the second matrix. So you can see here, number of columns of the first matrix is 2, number of rows of the second matrix is 2. So we can multiply. Now how to multiply? So you look at the process of multiplying two matrices. To multiply two matrices, and before performing actual multiplication, we can decide the order of the resultant matrix, which we will obtain after multiplying these two matrices A and B by our idea. The resultant matrix will be of order 3 by 4, because the number of rows in first matrix is 3, and number of columns in second matrix B is 4. So the resultant matrix will be of order 3 by 4. Now to multiply A and B, take the first row, take the rows of A. So from first matrix, we will consider only rows, and we will consider columns from the second man. So first I take this straw. This is first straw of A, and this is first column. So I multiply first straw with first column. So I am multiplying first row with first column, so it will create one position entry of the multiplication of the matrices A and B. So at the one position we will have multiplication of row 1 column 1. So we will have 1 into 8 plus 5 into 2 at the one position. For 1-2 position, we will have multiplication of the first row and second column. The second column is 4-5. So at this position, 1-2 position, we will have 1 into 4 plus 5 into 5. Similarly, for the 1-3 position, we will multiply first row with third column. So we will have 1 into 3 plus 5 into 8. For the next position, 1-4 position, we will multiply row 1 with 4th column of the matrix B. So we will multiply 1-5 with 1-6. We will have 1 into 1 plus 5 into 6. So we will have a 3x4 matrix. So this is the first row of that 3x4 matrix. Now we can calculate all the remaining terms similarly. So for this 2-1, this is 2-1 position. So for 2-1 position, we will multiply second row with first column. So here we will have 2 into 8 plus 7 into 2, and next we will have 2 into 4 plus 7 into 5. Next we will have 2 into 3 plus 7 into 8. So I have multiplied second row with third column. Next we will have 2 into 1 plus 7 into 6. Similarly, we calculate the last row. To calculate the last row, we will multiply third row with each column of the B. So first we multiply the third row 3-4 with the first column 8-2. So we will have 3 into 8 plus 4 into 2, then 3 into 4 plus 4 into 5, then 3 into 3 plus 4 into 8, then 3 into 1, 3 into 1 plus 4 into 6. Multiplication of the matrices is very important, that is why I am explaining this calculation in detail. So this is the process of multiplying two matrices. So every calculation is mentioned here. I repeat how I have calculated the entries. So for example, we take this end. So this is third row, third column. So this is 3-3 position. So to calculate the 3-3 position entry, what we will do, we will multiply the third row with third column. Multiply the third row of matrix A with the third column of matrix B. So we will have 3 into 3 plus 4 into 2. So this is the idea how to multiply, and then we can calculate all these terms, and after simplifying all these terms, we will have a 3x4 matrix. So the first position will be 18, and here we will have 29 Similarly, if you will calculate, so you will find 8540 plus 3, it will be 43, and 1 plus 30, so it will be 31. Similarly, you can calculate the remaining entry. This is the way of multiplying two matrices. So, I have explained this process with the help of example. Now, I give you symbolization through which you will be able to memorize the concept of matrix multiplication. So, look at that idea of symbolic representation of matrix multiplication. For symbolic representation of the matrix multiplication, I consider two matrices of order 3 by 3. So, suppose we have matrices A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. The first matrix and second matrix I take as alpha 1, beta 1, gamma 1, alpha 2, beta 2, gamma 2, alpha 3, beta 3, gamma 3. And suppose if we want to multiply these two matrices, then the product AB will be of this type. A1 alpha 1, B1 beta 1, C1 gamma 1. This will be the first entry. A1 alpha 1, B1 beta 1, C1 gamma 1. First entry. A1 alpha 2, B1 beta 2, C1 gamma 2. This is the second entry. And A1 alpha 3, B1 beta 3, C1 gamma 3. This will be the third entry. This will be 1-3 position entry of the product. And because A is of order 3 by 3 and B is of order 3 by 3, so matrix multiplication is compatible and the resultant matrix will be of order 3 by 3. So we can calculate the remaining 6 entries in similar. Further, if I write denote the first row of A by R1, and if I denote the second row of A by R2 and third row of A by R3, so I am taking rows from the first matrix A only, and then I will consider columns from the second matrix. So this is the first column of the second matrix B, the second column, and this is the third column of the matrix B. Using this R1, R2, R3 and C1, C2, C3 idea, I can write the multiplication of AB in this compact notation. So the first position will be R1, C1, second position will be R1, C2, third position will be R1, C3. Similarly, 2-1 position will be R2, C1, 2-2 position will be R2, C2, 2-3 position will be R2, C3, 3-1 position will be R3, C1, R3, C2, and 3-3 position will be R3, C2. So, using this compact notation, this last compact notation, you can easily keep the idea of matrix multiplication in your memory, and you can practice problems on multiplication of matrix. practicing to give you